train to Government Center is now arriving.
Boston's Green Line, one of the many light rail systems in the US, but only one of the few old ones dating back in the mid-1800s. Some people may know the Green Line as the first subway in America. It was also the most used light rail system, carrying 54 million passengers annually, but those numbers were beaten by Los Angeles Metro. As of now, there are four branches as well as an extension being built now as we speak. However, a long time ago, these weren't just the four branches, and the Green Line wasn't even called the Green Line until 1967. The city of Boston once had a trolley network of over 100 different routes.
The first trolley, or streetcars as another way of calling it, was a horse-drawn trolley that ran on March 26, 1856 between here at Central Square all the way to Bowdoin.
When the streetcars began operations, they were competing with the already existing omnibuses, which debuted in the 1820s. It wasn't long, however, for the streetcars to become popular and take over the streets of Boston and its neighbors.
But as the city grew, the streets became crowded and the horses were becoming unreliable, as packing passengers onto trolleys put too much work on the animals, leading to injuries. Not to mention the fact that they had to be fed and go to the bathroom somewhere.
An inventor named Franklin Julian Sprague had created the first electric streetcar that every city in the US began using, including Boston. So, in 1888, the first electric streetcar ran in Boston from the Alston Railroad Depot to Park Square. Electric streetcars were expensive when making new routes or converting old ones, but had minimal long-term costs and generated good profits. They were also far more reliable than horses, and even the fare prices were much cheaper. Eventually, all the horse routes were converted to electric trolleys, making Boston smell somewhat nicer. However, even when being able to move people around with well around 100 routes, congestion was still a problem by the end of the 19th century, especially in the downtown area. Trolleys, horse carriages, people, they were all packed. It was so bad, it was said that people moved faster by walking on the top of the trolley cars.
The solution to alleviate the congestion was to build tracks under Tremont Street. So, on September 1st, 1897, the first trolley car ran on the Tremont Street subway between Boylston and Park Street Station. This led to faster movement in the downtown area, and the system expanded over the next five decades. Many of the streetcars were built and operated by different companies. The big fish of them all was the Boston Elevated Railway, or Barry for short, and it ended up buying all the small companies in the end. By 1922, Barry had owned a total of 112 routes spanning 492 miles, but between 22 and 1940, 60 of those routes were either completely scrapped or converted to buses.
During this time period, automobiles were becoming apparent, leading people to driving in cars rather than using public transit, which led Barry to having a decrease in ridership. But with cars also came buses, and buses offered more flexibility through roads and were cheaper to operate than streetcars. 60 of the streetcar routes were converted to buses, as they were routes that didn't make any profits for Barry.
Now, this could be seen as a point of decline for the streetcars as their routes were being stripped away. Even so, 52 routes still remained in operation with a total of 390 miles of track. These routes ended up having a huge role during World War II. In fact, in 1940, the streetcars made 45% of Barry's profit, twice the amount made by either the buses or the newly built subways.
During World War II and 1946, the federal government set restrictions on motor fuel and tires. Since people couldn't have access to either, they had to use public transit as a means to get around. Barry was able to transport over 294 million passengers in 1940, and by 1946, it moved over 433 million passengers.
Unfortunately, in 1947, that's when it all finally... went downhill. In 1947, the federal government finally lifted its restriction on fuel and tires so that drivers could use their cars once more. In 1940, Barry had a very well-maintained infrastructure, but by 1945, it was doing poorly. Also in 1947, the state decided that Barry would be transformed from a private company to a public transportation system called the Metropolitan Transit Authority, or the MTA.
Trolleys were still running about in 1950, but were seeing a decline in ridership and profit due to automobiles. By that time, there were only 227 miles of track, almost half of what was in 1922. After 1950, one route after another got converted to a bus route as a cost-effective alternative to provide to the mass that still relied on public transit.
By 1964, the MTA was converted into the Massachusetts Bay Transportation Authority, or the T. By that time, only five streetcar routes had remained until the only four that we see today.
Ultimately, the 108 trolley routes were taken away by either the automobiles or the bus alternatives. The only reason we see the four today is because they're part of the old Tremont Street subway and have their own dedicated right-of-way. Thank you for watching this informative video. If you really want to know more about the Boston streetcar lines or their routes, I highly recommend reading the book Streetcar Lines of the Hub by Bradley H. Clark. You can get it at your local library or whatever. I will be making more videos about Boston's transit as well as other transit videos. In the future, I'm going to be looking at all the different routes that there once were, old and current, as well as a new one that's going to be coming out. Other than that, next stop.